I just told Jalen, you know, anytime you can, let's get you some easy buckets. You cut, just know I see you and I'll get it there.
Marcus Smart, of the top 40 assist men in the NBA entering today, you rank 6th in assist to turnover ratio. So that's just a great example of how you're making plays for others this season while making great reads on the other team and on the defense. And two of the guys you're making plays for this season are Jaylen Brown and Jason Tatum. It's crazy, but 40% of the assisted baskets that Jason Tatum has made this season, you have assisted. And actually 40% of Jaylen Brown's assisted baskets that he's made this season have been assisted by you. So we're going to take a look at kind of camaraderie and what you guys have going on the court in the next few plays. All right, Marcus, I love this action. One of my favorite plays that you guys have run this season. There's a ton of misdirection on it. What's your role on this particular play as you look for Jason Tatum here coming over on the wing?
I'm trying to lose my guy as quick as I can. You know, this is a scoring cut. If I could turn the corner, but this play, we were trying to get a three. As I get the ball, I take a dribble, and Tristan slightly brushes Drew and goes and gets Jason because, as you can see, Lopez is so far back, and this is why one of the reasons we run this play. It gives Jason Tatum, after he comes off the screen, more space, and my guy cannot leave to go help on Jason's shot, and it's a free wide-open shot for Jason, who we all know is going to knock that down 90% of the time.
In transition, you could have easily taken the shot, and it would have been a great shot. Yet, you catch it, and you're already looking at Jason Tatum coming down from the other end of the court, and you decide to pass it to him. Why do you make that decision on this play?
I wanted to really get Jason going. I wanted him to feel a great shot because him and Jalen, they draw so much attention that their shots are a lot tougher. And this is probably one of the most wide-open shots he's probably going to get ever. Because if those two are playing well, then the team is going to be playing well. So I wanted to turn down a good shot to get an even better shot, great shot to Jason, who's by himself, and to get him in the rhythm.
All right, here's a great example of your connection with Jaylen Brown. I just want to know, how did you even see this play developing?
You know, I've been playing with Jaylen 6 years of my career. I've always told those two, when I got the ball, especially in transition, whatever you do, I always see you. No matter what I'm doing, I always see you. So when I turn my back, I wanted to freeze Torrey and Prince because once I turn my back, he eases up because he doesn't think that I'm going to Jaylen and that Jaylen isn't a threat, which is perfect. And Jaylen does exactly what I expected him to do and what we talked about is when this guy turns his head or raises up, just go behind him and I'll find you.
Well, Marcus, we just saw it. You've actually spent about 70% of your time this season on the court at point guard. That's your highest by far rate since your rookie season. So you're owning that role this season. You're making plays for others, in particular, Jason Tatum and Jaylen Brown. And we appreciate you stopping in the TD Bank Film Study Room to break it all down.
Thank you, guys. Thank you for having me.